Welcome to Dare You, the show that makes your wildest dreams come true.
But dreams aren't for free. We want you to come up with the most imaginative, hilarious, or just downright gross dares that you are prepared to carry out. We'll be picking the best, and if you've got the guts to see it through, the experience of a lifetime is yours.
Coming up later, one lucky viewer will be travelling halfway around the world to meet up with these British babes of the pop world.
Hi, we're Atomic Kitten, and we want to know what you'd do for a chance to join us at the MTV Asia Awards in Singapore.
But first, we're looking for a serious football fanatic. Because right now on Dare You, we're offering one of you the chance to take to the pitch and swap passes with England legend and Spurs finest, Teddy Sheringham. Teddy is one of the most respected strikers in the Premier League and has been a key figure in the England squad, earning more than 50 international caps. He's not only a lethal finisher, but a clever and creative provider.
Hi, I'm Teddy Sheringham, and I'd like to know what you'd do to meet me to get the VIP treatment at White Hart Lane.
Now, we asked you to send in your maddest dares for your chance to win this incredible day out, and not surprisingly, we've been inundated with suggestions.
We've narrowed it down to the wackiest three, and trust us, these nutters are football crazy.
Hi, my name's Andy, and I'm 11 years old. I'm the biggest Tottenham fan you will ever see. And my dare is to dress up as a baby and head balloons full of gunge.
Hi, my name's Thomas, I'm 10 years old. If I ever got to meet Teddy Sheringham, my dare would be to jump into gunge full of seaweed and the smell would never come off.
Hello, my name's Johan. I'm 11 years old and my favourite player in the world's got to be Teddy Sheringham. To meet him, I have to do a dare, which is that I have to dress up like a girl and go to the streets and sell roses to everyone.
Well, we've heard what those three die-hard Teddy fans are prepared to do to meet their hero, but who do you think has the dare that we just can't live without? And the man of the match is... Andy! I just can't wait to see him making a mess in his nappy. Well, I'm here at Andy's local park and he's got a football match today and he's been told to turn up a little bit early. Now, as usual, it's going to be a complete surprise for him when we pounce, but what I want to know is he still prepared to go through with his dare? If not, or if he doesn't complete it properly, then it could be Thomas or Johan taking his place and meeting Teddy Sheringham. We'll find out in just a sec, so I better go and hide. Let's go, go. Come round here. Andy, yeah. Come on out. I'm Steve from Nickelodeon.
Hiya.
Nice to meet you. How you doing?
I'm okay.
Now, I think you've got a pretty good idea why I'm here surprising you at your local park. This is your chance to meet England ace Teddy Sheringham. Look at that excited face. And also your chance to be a special guest at the home of Spurs.
Oh yeah?
Why? Well, the big question is, Andy, listen, this is what I want to know. Are you still prepared to go through with the world's messiest game of keepy up?
Yeah.
You are? Fantastic. Well, Yolly is setting up your dare right now, so shall we go? He's so surprised. Come on, let's go.
Hello, Steve.
Hey, Yolly, this is Andy.
Hello, Andy, how are you?
I'm okay.
Good.
Now then, what are the rules of Andy's dare?
Oh, you're going to like this one. We're going to dress you up as a baby. I've got this pretty little suit for you here. Do you like it?
Yeah, I do.
Yes, I reckon it's your colour. And using your baby head, you have to burst at least 10 of these custard-filled balloons, okay?
Alright.
Alright, so if you manage to complete it, then the dream is yours. If you don't, then someone else is going to meet your hero.
Indeed. Okay. So, do you understand all the rules?
Yeah.
Good. But before you do anything, I want to find out how much of a baby you really are.
Cuckoo! Mama, baby need potty. Too late.
Now, we just couldn't turn them down. They begged us, they pleaded with us, so we just had to let them. Andy's mates will be delivering the projectiles.
Heading the ball is a very important skill to learn, especially in the English game. It's a good opportunity to score goals as well, isn't it?
Now, Andy's usual position is at centre-back.
There he has to be strong and commanding, organising the defence and repelling all attacks. He spends a lot of time training to improve his skills, but I don't think anything could prepare him for his Custard Cup final.
I've never headed balloons filled with custard, but it sounds quite fun and I wouldn't mind a go at it.
Andy, I've got to be careful where I tread here. I think you've been humiliated enough. That was absolutely hilarious. How do you feel?
I feel absolutely custardy, mucky and horrible.
It was brilliant.
You were absolutely fantastic. I think you definitely deserve to go meet Teddy Sheringham.
Yeah, actually, we're going to have to go now. You haven't even got time to get changed before you meet him, but you don't mind, do you? I'm only joking, mate, of course. We can't have you meeting a top England star dressed like that, can we? Are you excited?
Very.
Good lad. Yolly, we'll see you later.
Come
and follow me.
Tottenham Hotspur are giants of the English football scene. Today, Andy's getting access to areas that most fans never see.
Andy, can you believe we're actually sat here in the changing room?
I can't believe it. It's amazing.
It's wicked, isn't it?
Yeah.
What do you reckon it's like in here on match day?
Probably they're like all talking about their tactics, and if you're losing at half-time, the manager will be absolutely shouting at them.
The atmosphere in the dressing room before a game is quite intense, and we're there to win, so it's very competitive and all raring to go before that 3 o'clock kickoff.
Walking out the tunnel is like playing for them, just imagining all them fans just cheering for you. Felt really good.
Well, there's nobody on the pitch playing at the moment, is there? But
no.
There's a training ground just around the corner, and that's where the guys are training right now, and Teddy Sheringham's there. So what do you say we head over there and have a little word with him?
I think so.
All right, mate, come on.
Watching Teddy and the team training was absolutely amazing. It's one in a lifetime thing to do, and it's just superb.
As if watching his heroes wasn't enough, half the Spurs squad are soon over shaking Andy's hand. And even manager Glenn Hoddle joins in the fun.
Is that why your hair's gone like that? All that custard?
Why are you in all this?
Hey? It's okay. It's going upside down, clean the toilet out.
But it's his idol Teddy that Andy's really desperate to meet.
This is Andrew, and he is a wannabe Spurs player.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Meeting Teddy was the best thing ever happened to me in my life. It just felt weird close up to go to him, and it's just really nice.
If you wasn't a football player, what would you be?
Don't really know. I didn't really do anything else when I was little, so all I wanted to be was a footballer, and I was lucky enough to be able to do that.
When I was playing with him, I was like, oh my God, he's really strong because he's like built up muscles and all that. On Teddy Sheringham, I was trying to get the ball off him, and it's really hard to get the ball off him because he was barging me and all that. And it was good fun.
Really enjoyed meeting Andy today. Looks like he's a player for the future. You never know, we might be seeing him at White Hart Lane one day.
One more dream has come true, but do not go away, because after the break, one lucky Nickelodeon viewer will be jetting off to the other side of the world to a top award ceremony with the chance to mingle with some of pop's biggest names.
Hi, we're Atomic Kitten.
Join us at the MTV Awards in Singapore after the break.
Welcome back to Dare You, the show where your dreams are only a dare away. Before the break, we saw Andy complete the cold custard challenge in order to meet his football hero, Teddy Sheringham.
But now someone else will be showing us what they're made of on Dare You. We've pulled out all the stops to offer one lucky viewer a trip of a lifetime. Up for grabs a VIP ticket to the MTV Awards in Singapore and a chance to rub shoulders with their favourite pop stars in the heart of the exotic Far East.
Hi, we're Tom McKinnon.
And we can't wait to see who's going to win this fantastic trip. Oh!
A truly awesome prize, I'm sure you'll agree. Now, the only thing standing between one lucky viewer and the airport is a dare.
And just as we thought, we've been inundated with wacky, gross and embarrassing challenges, but only three can get through to this very testing stage. So let's have a look at what they're prepared to do.
Hello, my name is Lucy and I'm 12 years old. And I would love to go to the MTV Awards because it would be like a dream come true. And my dare is to dress up as a pumpkin. And if I spoke at all, then I would have to get splattered with eggs at the end of the day.
Hi, I'm Louise, and I'm 12 years old, and I really want to go to the MTV Awards. But to do that, I'm going to have to dress up in a fat, huge sumo wrestling suit and go back to my old primary school and serve all the teachers their dinners.
Hi. My name's Bethany, I'm 12 years old, and I would love to go to the MTV Awards to say that I've been right across the world to Singapore to meet all the celebrities that all my friends like as well. My challenge would be to go to an Italian restaurant and eat the most disgusting pizza that could be made.
Some bizarre and cringeworthy dares there, but who would you like to see put themselves on the line for this mega prize? And the lucky person is Bethany. No, I'm not shopping for a pink coat. I've already got one. I'm actually here to surprise Bethany. Now, she's in town shopping for some new outfits. She's got no idea that we are here. The big question is, has she got the bottle to go through with her dare? If not, then Louise or Lucy could be in for a chance of winning that dream. Now, we'll find out in just a second because I think she's coming in right now. Hi, Bethany.
Hello.
Bethany, hi. I'm Steve from Nickelodeon.
Hello.
Nice to meet you. Hi, Mum, Dad, and Brother Max. Now, I think you've got a pretty good idea why I'm here, don't you?
Yeah.
You wrote to Nickelodeon. What did you want to do? You wanted to go somewhere.
To the MTV Awards.
You did?
Oh, my God, I don't believe it.
Look at the surprise. Well, I chose you, Bethany, because I thought your dare was stomach-churning stuff. Now, what was it that you dared to do?
I dared to eat the most disgusting pizza that could be made.
Fantastic. Well, the big question is, dare you go through with it? Will you eat the pizza from hell?
I will eat the pizza from hell.
When I was surprised, I started crying because I was really shocked and I didn't know whether to feel scared or happy or nervous. I was excited about going to Singapore and walking along the red carpet at the MTV Awards.
I'm here at Bethany's favourite pizza restaurant, although believe me, after today's dare, I don't think she's going to want to return because we have given regular chef Carlos two new trainees. Yes, her two cousins, Tom and Hayden, will be adding the ingredients to the pizza with one mission in mind, to make her heave.
When the moon hits your eye like a bigger pizza pie, that's amore.
My nightmare pizza ingredients would be celery with mustard and coriander on top.
Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling.
So what's next?
A banana.
Any kind of fish, sushi, and mushrooms.
Oh, you hate, because you can smell mushrooms a mile off.
So what would you definitely not want on a pizza?
Anchovies.
Brussels sprouts, jelly, and anchovies.
You like anchovies, though?
Not with jelly.
Jelly, go on, then.
Well, there is a pizza being prepared for you that's, may have a few things like anchovies on it. And we've got some special people who are preparing it especially for you. It's actually your cousins, Tom and Hayden. Why are you laughing? Do you think they're gonna...
I know they're gonna be cruel to me.
Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Oh,
that's amore.
That was hilarious.
Well done.
How do you feel?
Very sick.
Not too sick, I hope, but you'll be glad to know you have successfully completed your dare, hasn't she?
She has indeed, that's right. And you better go home, start packing. I want you to get your best outfit because you and I are jetting off on a 747 to pop heaven, baby.
Hang on, what do you mean you and I? Don't you mean the three of us?
No, you're staying here. You've got to hold the fort. And actually, whilst you're at it, you wouldn't mind popping round and feeding my goldfish for me, would you?
Great.
So here we are, 10,000 miles later, away from home, Singapore.
When I saw the skyscrapers, I was amazed because they just looked so high. I couldn't imagine working on the top floor.
Singapore is a tiny island in Southeast Asia. It's less than 100 miles from the equator and would once have been covered in tropical rainforest. Nowadays, though, it's a modern metropolis full of skyscrapers and, for the next couple of days, pop stars.
Singapore is amazing.
It's lively, it's really hot.
But if you, and you could look up at all the skyscrapers and it was like, I felt like Lois Lane. I was just waiting for Superman to come, but it didn't arrive.
When we went to the beach, it was really hot. We were the only ones that were sweating because we're the English and we're not used to the weather over here. I felt like I was in a tropical island. In Chinatown, I bought this red hat with a black plaque down the back. It's supposed to bring you luck. Yoli made me buy it, but I thought I looked stupid.
Oh, I don't know about you, Bethany, but this is definitely the life. Right, say we're at the awards.
Right.
You're like the journalist that everyone wants to talk to, and you get to speak to Atomic Kitten, your favourite band, yeah?
Yeah.
What kind of things would you ask them?
What they're at the awards for tonight.
Good question, like it, yeah.
And where they got all their great clothes from.
Alright, speaking of outfits and girly things like that, I reckon you and I need to go back to the hotel and glam up for tonight for the awards.
Okay.
Oh, you're excited?
Yeah.
Yeah. But first of all, we need to go and pick up our VIP tickets.
Okay.
Bethany thinks that we're on our way to collect our tickets for tonight's show, but we've got a big surprise for her. Yes, there are three girls eager to meet her. And surprise! Hello, Bethany.
Hello, it's
Bethany.
We've been hiding on the floor for ages. Them horrible people at Nickelodeon made me eat pizza.
I hate
Brussels sprouts.
So you've got some questions, haven't you?
What's the best part about being famous?
Ooh, I think going on stage, like things like tonight when we're going to go to the MTV Awards, that's going to be massive. And, you know, when we go on stage and you know, all the people sing the songs back to you, it's really exciting.
What clothes did you get to wear and what was your favourite thing?
Things like what you're wearing today.
Yeah, pretty much
like black vest, thing. I've got them trainers, I've got pants like this. I think you look like a cool kitten.
I've got a very large collection of these hats.
What will you be doing tonight at the MTV Awards?
We'll be performing.
We're going to sing Tide is High.
And we'll present an award.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll be looking at Robbie.
How we've got two different outfits and they're all very glam. So it's dead exciting.
Now we've got to go and get ready, haven't we?
Yeah.
Mwah. Bye bye, darling.
Bye.
You're absolutely beautiful.
Thank you.
Mwah.
Good luck for tonight. We'll hope to see
you.
Then.
Thank you.
See you later.
See you later, Bethany.
Bye. Bye.
I bought four outfits with me today for the MTV Awards, but I don't know which one to wear. The first one's a long white flowy skirt with a white vest top, but I think it's a bit too pretty. The second one's a pair of green army combats with a tight black top and a string vest over it, but I think it's a bit too casual. The third one is a pair of jeans and a black top with writing all over it, but I think that was a bit too punky. And the one I'm wearing for the awards, well, you just have to wait and see.
Here they are, Blue. Hello, everyone.
Hello,
Nickelodeon. Nickelodeon.
What's up, man? Is this England?
Yes.
I'm Miss Own, man.
It's Nickelodeon.
I'm Miss Own.
You're watching JU, and I'm the number one R&B star, David Tao.
Woohoo!
Hello to all the JU viewers.
Have you ever done a really crazy dare for something?
I ran around outside in my underwear in the snow.
She just squashed me in the car door.
That's not very nice. Could you do us?
Well, thank you. Could you say you're watching Dare You?
I'm watching Dare You.
It's time for the actual awards, and here I am by the red carpet. The crowds are going wild. Press have come from all over the world to try and catch the stars, but I'm here to meet the biggest star of them all. She's got a VIP ticket, and she knows how to use it. Yes, it's our very own Bethany Muir.
Bethany, good luck, sweetheart.
Oh my goodness. Here she comes now, the biggest star of them all. Signing an autograph with her mum. Oh, fantastic. She looks absolutely gorgeous. Bethany!
Hello!
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
You look absolutely amazing.
Thank you.
Are you nervous?
No.
Did you make your mum walk behind you?
Yes.
Right, you're going to go inside, make sure you get the best seats and have a fantastic time.
Thank you.
You're a star.
When I got on the red carpet, I was scared that I was going to fall over. But thankfully, I didn't. I felt like a star. I thought the show was brilliant. I'm going to make all my friends jealous when I get home.
Hello, Singapore!
Yeah!
Hello, Asia! Hello, planet Earth!
Robbie Williams was gorgeous, and I thought he sang really well. Atomic Kitten were brilliant. Blue were brilliant. I'll just say all of them were.
Well, I don't know about you, Bethany, but I thought that was amazing.
It was wonderful.
Was it a dream come true?
Definitely.
And what would you say was your best bit overall?
By far, meeting the Atomic Kitten.
They're cool, aren't they?
Yeah, they're great.
And what about walking down the red carpet?
Yep, that was a favourite as well.
So thumbs up all round?
Definitely.
We did well. And unfortunately, that's it for Dare You in Singapore. Please join us next time when we make someone else's dreams come true.